The process is the same, regardless of what company we're talking about, whether it's a Google, whether it's an Oracle, whether it's Microsoft, whatever. I think that the process is going exactly the same. We go through the same process. What you need to think about last week, I was at the plane. illustrated this very, very well for me. A Nigerian, just last week, and this boy was talking about his wishes and his intentions and all that. And he was lamenting and saying that his forefathers was more or less upset, very angry about his forefathers. But why this young man and not have gone to buy all perfume? But had they bought perfume, his forefathers, had they bought perfume, then today he would be a multimillionaire, he would not be worried, he would sell plots of land. Anytime that he needs money, he would just sell a plot of land and it would be okay. Now, before we challenge that kind of thinking, right, because that's he was speaking from his mind, we find that ourselves, all of us, if you think that every now and then we wish that we were called Yemi Rockefeller or Sergi Trump, Econ Toyota, or even Crown Prince Jennifer. Very easy. You inherit wealth. You just walk into your billions. No stress, no sweat. You inherit Toyota. Okay, maybe Toyota has problems today, so you can inherit Honda. But the point being that developing takes work. Developing takes work. Even if you are going to inherit, what we tend to forget is that you have to go back to the beginning. It started somewhere. Whether it's a Rockefeller in the oil and gas sector, or the Trump in properties and development, or Toyota in manufacturing, or even the Crown Prince in King Fahd in Saudi, we all started somewhere. So we have to go back to the origin for us to determine where we want to go to. So what's the origin? The origin that I found for any company, regardless of how big they're going to get, is that you have to start strong. Regardless. And this is very important because as much as this seems like logic, I have seen over and over and over again that a lot of people that go and start their businesses do not start strong. It seems logical, but they don't. Many people, as they're about to start business, they determine where they want to go into, and the next thing they're doing is that they're starting very big. They're not starting small. Every company has to start small for it to grow. For us, because we're doing a case study, I've been asked to do a case study, so as I got the examples, I'll go back to Sahara and bring back and forth so that at least you can relate it. We started 14 years ago. I think the office was about the size of this room. There were three of us in that office, just three, my three partners, that we started. It took almost a year of just three of us. We were doing everything, we were the drivers, we were the photocopying, we were the cleaners, we were everything together. It took almost a year before we employed one person. And then we found out that we were always out on the road, and somebody had to sit in the office to at least take phone calls and receive their service. We employed one jack of all trades, just one. He became the receptionist, he was the one who received guests, would go in the office, sit down, go out, buy stationery, and do all kinds of things. But one person. It took almost a year for us to move from three people to four people. Probably another year and a half, close to 2 years before we became 7 people. And there we selected the people that we knew had to go out for marketing and had to go out and join us again, the paperwork that we needed to become 100%. But within that period of time of almost 2 years, we were already doing the business that we had employed 20 people, if we needed to. But we did not need to. We didn't need to show, or we didn't believe that there was a need to show that we had arrived at anything. So we were doing everything. I remember I had a briefcase, I had a printer in it, I had all my letterheads, I had everything, all the codes, and I would sit down in any office that we get. As we were discussing, typing the contract, reading it out, and signing it there, and then before I leave. There was no time, no need to go back to the office and start calling people and type this one, we'd read ourselves. should be able to employ 413,000. It's very important. Sorry, 430 people. It's very, very important because as you're going to start up your business, start small. Do not take on unnecessary overheads. It's a major, major killer for most people. Don't take on unnecessary overheads. Now, the next point is the economic sector where you're going to start up your business. We're talking about billions. That sector has to have the capacity to return billions. It just doesn't make sense. Again, it seems logical. But if you want to grow your business to earn billions, the sector that your business operates in must have the capacity to return billions. If not, you're just going to be limited by the size of that market. That should make sense. So, what did we do for us? For us in Sahara, we looked again at the sectors and we went into the energy sector. Every business that we do, every client, today we have 14 different companies under the Sahara Group, but each one of them is in a sector that can achieve $1 billion and more in each of those sectors. And that is key for anybody who wants to do business. Because you need to prepare businesses. You can do businesses and businesses, but your sector, if you really want to hit $1 billion and above, your sector and where you choose must have the capacity to must have the capacity to hit $1 billion. This is often overlooked. Again, it seems like logic. But a lot of people have it. It takes hard work. It takes unbelievable hard work. Unbelievable. When I say unbelievable hard work, I mean unbelievable hard work. There's a book I read recently called The Outliers by Malcolm Caldwell. For anybody who is aspiring to differentiate themselves from the normal to the exceptional, I suggest that you get you'll be amazed as to things that you just think are coincidence or normal in life that are not coincidence. But one of the chapters in the research that he did says that there is a 10,000 hour rule, which basically states that for most people, whether you're a musician, anything in life that you're going to do, once you focus on it, different people you may have two people of exactly the same talent, and one of them, both talented, but one of them will rise much higher than the other. And why? Because of the amount of time one spends practicing and doing what he's doing over and over and over again. Now, they calculated and did a lot of studies, but they calculated that basically it takes about 10,000 hours of working on something for you to master it and complete it. And they checked it with football players, they checked it with basketball players, they checked it with businessmen, we checked it with computer programmers, different things. So Bill Gates, Bill Joy, Larry Ellison, all of them the same thing. And after I read it, I looked back at it and I found that it was about the same thing. It took about 10 years of consistent work. It's roughly, no matter how you do it, almost about 10 years of consistent hard work for you to master your area of expertise. About 10 years, roughly. And so, regardless of whether, and when you think about it, you see people differentiating themselves, you see it in sports. That's why you see the same Bolt or Rooney or Beckham becoming higher than Ronaldo, becoming higher than others. You see it in faith as well, like Ebwe or Oyedepo. The same thing, rising up in faith. It is a lot of time and a lot of hard work. So what do we find? At least in our own case, again, going back as a case study, at the beginning, going back 14 years and almost up to maybe 5 years ago, thereabouts, this was almost a constant thing. You come into the office almost on Sundays, and it was almost like a work. Saturdays was clear. We work Saturdays for. So Mondays to Saturdays for. Most Sundays will be there as well, working. And that's what's increasing hours for getters. We'll find people working till 12 to midnight, sometimes 1 a.m. and they're back in the office at 8. It takes a passion, it takes a dedication to the job for you to be able to do that. But this was what we found out. It wasn't planned, it wasn't set, it wasn't that we